Good morning children, welcome back to the social session. In the previous session we were trying to understand about expansion of democracy, in which we are going to learn about Libya and Myanmar. Yesterday I was sharing with you about the Libya's background and how Libya got freedom from Italy colonization, and it was under the rule of Idris, King Idris. But King Idris could not distribute the wealth of Libya, that is oil and natural gas, which was found in 1959, was enjoyed only by some families of Libya. After that there was a military rebellion which has taken place in Libya in 1969, where Muammar Gaddafi led 70 young army officers had brought the entire kingdom of Libya under their control and declared that Libya will be socialist Arab Republic. Okay, socialist Libyan Arab Republic they have declared, because Islam was the most popular majority religious faith in Libya. And this entire Libya, which was led by Muammar Gaddafi, will be controlled by 12 army officers under the control of RCC. RCC bole to Revolutionary Command Council hai. Iske hisab se pura administration jo hai wo chalta tha. And as we read, Libyan society was initially tribal, led by the families of tribal chiefs, and there were many fights also within the tribes. Ek tribe ke rebellion group aur ek tribe ke group se lad rahe the. There were fighting between the tribal groups and tribal sects also. People were more concerned about their own tribe and their development, and it's a honor that about the welfare of all the people. Most people were poor and they were nomadic animal herders. Nomadic bole to kya hai ji? Nomadic means the people who doesn't lead a settled life. Those who move from one place to another place are called as nomadic. They are called as nomadic. So they were moving from one place to another place. One place to another. They are called as nomadic. So most of the people in Libya were nomadic animal herders. Animal wo ghas ke liye leke jaate nahi cattle ko. Most of the families were that. So they were also illiterate, and women were confined only to parda system. That means like we have burqa system in the country. So this parda system was there. They were not allowed to participate in any public activities. In no public activity women were allowed to participate. It was like a Shariat law which was imposed in Libya. The new regime has instituted many reforms which led to the rapid growth of Libya, especially nationalization of oil resources. Kya hai wo? Ab tak ek hi family ke paas jo tha resources pura, wo pura गवर्नमेंट ले ली. नेशनलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेस, ऑयल रिसोर्सेस वॉज डन, एंड वॉट एवर इनकम दे जनरेट फ्रॉम द सेल ऑफ दिस ऑयल विल बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड एंड विल बी स्पेंट ऑन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द कंट्री. एंड ए प्रोग्राम फॉर एक्सटेंशन ऑफ कल्टिवेशन, गिविंग इरीगेटेड लैंड टू द पुअर वर्कर्स इन ऑर्डर टू एंड नोमैडिज्म वॉज ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड. फ्री यूनिवर्सल एडुकेशन फॉर ऑल इंक्लूडिंग वुमेन. फ्री यूनिवर्सल एडुकेशन, ये तो हमारे इंडिया में भी नहीं है अभी तक. फ्री यूनिवर्सल एडुकेशन. ओके, सो वी आर स्टिल इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ कोर्स राइट टू एडुकेशन इज गिवन वेरी लेटली हियर इन 2009, बट दिस वाज इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन लिबिया इन 1969 आफ्टर मुम्मार गडाफी हैज कम इन टू पावर. सो फ्री यूनिवर्सल एडुकेशन इंक्लूडिंग वुमेन. वुमेन वर नॉट अलाउड टू कम आउट ऑफ देयर हाउसेज बिफोर दैट, बट ही स्टार्टेड ब्रिंगिंग चेंजेस इन द लिबियन सोसाइटी. So free medical care for all, distribution of share of oil profits among all citizens, development of highly subsidized housing scheme for all. A major reform undertaken was to ensure freedom and equal status to women. They have made sure that women are treated well and they are given equal status in all opportunities. So women were now allowed to have a property and business, and they can take up jobs also in the government. As a result of these, Libya was able to achieve highest levels of social welfare in Africa, in the entire Africa. Libya, which was one of the backward country in Africa, has become such a prosperous country because of these reforms. So average life expectancy increased from 50 years to 77 years in Libya, and literacy rate for both men and women is over 90% today. Even India's literacy rate is only 75.04% children, but whereas Libya's literacy rate is 90%. Okay, both men and women. And in this 75%, you know, India's literacy rate of women is only 65%. Still 35% of women are illiterate in our country. 70 years after independence, I'm talking. So, whereas the situation in Libya was far more better, even though it was under the military control, but they have implemented these social welfare measures. So, it was very difficult to encourage bringing economic democratic participation of all people in Libya due to conditions of tribalism, because many of the people got divided or sects into the tribals, and nomadism was there. There was no settled life, and illiteracy was there, and restrictions on women was difficult. So these all things were brought under control only because of the military rule. So further about Libya and its development, what changes has made them to come together and fight for the democracy, we'll see in the next class, children. Until then, take care. Thank you.